إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم تسليمًا كثيرًا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله. Indeed, the most truthful of speech is the book of Allah. وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. And the best guidance we have is the guidance of our beloved messenger Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. وشر الأمور محدثاتها. And the worst of affairs are those things we newly invent into this religion of ours. وكل محدثة بدعة. And everything we newly invent into this religion of ours is an innovation. وكل بدعة ضلالة. And every innovation is misguidance and it leads astray. وكل ضلالة في النار. Every going astray, every misguidance is in the hellfire. ثم أما بعد. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah Azza wa Jalla says, إن الصلاة كانت على المؤمنين كتابا موقوتا. Allah Azza wa Jalla, He says in the Quran what means, verily the prayer is enjoined on the believers. Those who want to be believers, in the eyes of Allah Azza wa Jalla, the prayers are enjoined upon them at fixed hours. ثم قال الله وأقيموا الصلاة وآتوا الزكاة وما تقدموا لأنفسكم من خير تجدوه عند الله إن الله بما تعملون بصير. And Allah Azza wa Jalla, He says what means, and establish the prayer. Don't just perform it, establish it in its time and with humility and khushu, and give the zakah, and whatever of deeds you do, that deeds that Allah loves, that you send forth for yourselves before you, you shall find it with Allah, and certainly Allah is the all-seer of what you do. ثُمَّ قَالَ اللَّهُ إِنَّ الْمُنَافِقِينَ يُخَادِعُونَ اللَّهُ وَهُوَ خَادِعُهُمْ وَإِذَا قَامُوا إِلَى الصَّلَاةِ قَامُوا كُسَالَى يُرَاءُونَ النَّاسَ وَلَا يَذْكُرُونَ اللَّهَ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. And Allah says what means, verily the munafiqeen, the hypocrites, they seek to deceive Allah, but Allah is the one who knows about them, and He is the one who deceives them. And when they stand up for salah, they stand up with laziness, just to be seen of men, and they do not remember Allah in their salah except for a little. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, as we've been talking about the salah the past few weeks, we see that Allah Azza wa Jal, He blessed His Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and He blessed this ummah with the gift and the blessing of salah. Because the salah is a gift and a blessing truly from Allah, a chance for us to beg Him, to ask Him for guidance, to seek His forgiveness and His mercy, to get closer to Him and to His pleasure. And in addition, from His mercy was that He placed special rewards, special virtues for certain salahs, certain prayers at certain times. And we should remind ourselves of these virtues that come with these five obligatory prayers. عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إن أثقل الصلاة على المنافقين صلاة العشاء وصلاة الفجر ولو يعلمون ما فيهما لأتوهما ولو حبوة. Ibn Majah, he records this hadith in his narration of a hadith, and it is sahih. The Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, the most burdensome prayer, the most burdening prayer on the hypocrites are the Isha prayers and the Fajr prayers. And if they only knew the reward for them, they truly believed in the reward that Allah promised for the ones who come and do this in Jama'ah, they would come to them even if they had to crawl. Even if they had to crawl, they would come. And we've seen that people do this when there's the likes of food or the likes of some dunya reward. What they would do, what they would go to extents, standing hours out in the freezing cold just to be the first one in to buy that computer for a special deal or whatever it may be. Yet when it comes to the salah, the people, if they understood the value of Isha and Fajr, they would come even if they had to crawl. وعن عائشة رضي الله عنها قالت قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ركعة الفجر خير من الدنيا وما فيها. رواه النسائي. In this hadith, which is authentic in the Sunnah of Nisa'i, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, the two rak'ahs of Sunnah before the Fajr prayer, the two rak'ahs of Sunnah before the Fajr prayer, they are better than this world and everything in it. This is the value of them. And you don't have to read long in those two rak'ahs. The Sunnah of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, most typically that we do, in the first rak'ah, Surah Al-Kafirun, in the second, Surah Al-Ikhlas, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدٌ. Short rak'ahs, but better than this world and what was in it if you truly believed. وعن عثمان بن عفان رضي الله عنهما رضي الله عنه عفوا قال سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول من صلى العشاء في جماعة فكأنه صلى نصف الليل ومن صلى الصبح في جماعة فكأنما صلى الليل كله. This hadith, which is authentic in the Sahih of Muslim, Uthman radiallahu anhu, he narrated that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the one who performs Isha in Jama'ah, in the congregation, in the masjid, it will be as if they stood half the night in prayer. And the one who completes it by coming to the masjid to pray Fajr in Jama'ah, it will be like they stood up the whole night in prayer. Even if you go home and sleep, this is the reward, the weight of these prayers. And although we'll have another khutbah about reminding us the value of the men doing their salawat in the masjid, yani this shows you the value of these prayers, not just being done in the masjid, but just being done at all. And Abu Bakr ibn Umar ibn Urwayba al-Thaqafi, he said that his father said, سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول لن يلد النار من صلى قبل طلوع الشمس وقبل غروبها. رواه النسائي. The Prophet ﷺ, in the authentic hadith, which is sahih, he was heard to have said, he will never enter the hellfire, the one who prays before the sun rises, يعني فجر, and the one who prays before the sun sets, يعني صلاة العصر. Look at the value, the protection you're giving yourself, the chance you're giving yourself for Allah's mercy to be able to enter Jannah by safeguarding these prayers. وعن سمرة بن جندب قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من صلى الصبح فهو في ذمة الله عز وجل. رواه ابن ماجه. In this authentic hadith, we see in the Sunnah of Ibn Majah, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, whoever offers the Fajr prayer, they are in the protection of Allah, the Mighty and the Sublime. Who would turn away that protection? The protection of the Creator that created you and me and everything that exists. From above his arsh, above his throne, above the seven heavens separate from his creation. Promising you protection if you safeguard those prayers. وعن أبو بكر ابن أبي موسى رضي الله عنه قال قال أبي أن قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من صلى البردين دخل الجنة. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said in the authentic hadith in Sahih al-Bukhari, whoever prays the two cool prayers, this is Salat al-Fajr and Salat al-Asr, they will go to paradise. Narration after narration, stressing not just that this is a gift, not that this is just a duty we owe to Allah, being our Creator, being the Lord of the heavens and the earth, but one that will get us protection in this life and the next. Yet we squander these and we lose out on the reward. عن أبي بكر and Jundab ibn Sufyan رضي الله عنه, he said that the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم said من صلى الصبح فهو في ذمة الله فانظر يا ابن آدم. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, in Sahih Muslim, this hadith is narrated, he said, he who offers the dawn or the Fajr prayer, they will come under the protection of Allah, so O son of Adam, beware lest Allah should call you to account in any respect from withdrawing his protection. Al-Tibi, rahimahullah, He said the reason why the Fajr prayer is singled out here is because it entails hardship. You getting up, sacrificing sleep, going and making wudu, even though the weather may be cold, coming out to the masjid, performing it, because it will show your sincerity and your iman. And whoever is a sincere believer is under the protection of Allah Azza wa Jal. This hadith also shows us that the one who prays Fajr prayer, this person is under the care and protection of Allah, and it is even more sinful that you would harm this person. And likewise, it's a warning against abandoning and neglecting Fajr prayer, because you would be abandoning and transgressing the covenant between a person and his Lord, because we know this is the prayer. From the authentic hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, الْعَهْدَ الَّذِي بَيْنَنَا وَبَيْنَهُمُ الصَّلَاةِ فَمَنْ تَرَكَهَا فَقَدْ كَفَرَ. That the covenant between the believer and the one who does not believe is the salah. Whoever breaks the salah, whoever abandons the salah, فَقَدْ كَفَرَ. He has committed kufr, disbelief. And according to the Jamhur, he exits the religion of Al-Islam. So we should be mindful of this. Do not abandon Fajr prayer, nor be heedless about it, lest you break the covenant that exists between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Shaykh Abdullah ibn Abdul Aziz ibn Baz, rahimahullah, he said with regards to the person who deliberately delays the prayer until after the time is over, or he sets his alarm clock for 7 a.m. to get up for work, even though the Fajr prayer is over at 6:50, let's say, that this person who sets his alarm clock late, so he will not get up on time, he is deliberately not praying, and he has committed a great evil, according to the ulama. But is this kufr, disbelief, or not? He said, here is the difference of opinion amongst the ulama. But if he does not deny the prayers obligatory, then the majority of the ulama say that this may not be major kufr. But some of the scholars held that is major kufr, and we discussed this in the khutbah a few weeks ago. That would take him outside of the pale of Islam because of the hadith بين الرجل وبين الكفر والشرك ترك الصلاة. That between a man and kufr, being a disbeliever and a mushrik, a polytheist, is the abandonment of the prayer. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, we see that Allah Azza wa Jal, He said, وَالْمُسْتَغْفِرِينَ بِالْأَصْحَابِ. When Allah in Surah Ali Imran, He says, and those who pray and they beg Allah's pardon in the last hours of the night. Zayd ibn Aslam, he said that with respect to this ayah, it's referring to those who pray Fajr in Jama'ah, Fajr in congregation in the masjid. And the ayat in Surah Al-Sajda, تَتَجَافَ جُنُوبُهُمْ عَنِ الْمَضَاجِعِ يَدْعُونَ رَبَّهُمْ خَوْفًا وَطَمَعًا وَمِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ. Regarding this ayah in Surah Al-Sajda, their sides forsake their beds to invoke their Lord in fear and in hope. Abu Darda and Al-Dahhaq, they said this refers to Isha and Fajr prayers in Jama'ah. Ayat after ayat, hadith after hadith, we see the value, the virtue, the reward, the blessings that come with those who establish their prayers and establish them in the masajid. Umar ibn Khattab, radiallahu anhu, he said, to attend Fajr in Jama'ah in the masjid is dearer to me than spending the whole night in tahajjud, in prayer. And you have those who, alhamdulillah, they get up for tahajjud, but because of it, they cannot wake up for Fajr prayer. And because of that, they lose out on the fariyadah, on the obligation. Because of doing something, although it is very light, it led them to leave a fariyadah, and we cannot choose this. It's like the one who in Ramadan, they come for tarawih, but then they abandon the Isha prayer outside of inside and outside of Ramadan. This is like an oxymoron. It doesn't make sense. Because the obligations are the first things we must fulfill. Allah Azza wa Jalla, He said, أَقْمُ الصَّلَاةِ لِذُلُوكِ الشَّمْسِ إِلَى غَسَقِ اللَّيْلِ وَقُرْآنَ الْفَجْرِ إِنَّ قُرْآنَ الْفَجْرِ كَانَ مَشْهُودًا. Allah says what means perform the salah. Establish it, not just the performance. Establish the prayer from midday till the darkness of the night. In this is the four salawat of Dhuhr, Asr, Maghrib, and Isha. And recite the Qur'an in the early dawn, in the Fajr prayer, verily the recitation of the Qur'an, in the early prayer, it is witnessed by the Malaika, attended by the ones who are in charge of mankind by day and by night. This refers to not reading out of the Mus'haf at that time, but you lengthening your recitation in Fajr prayer itself. It is witnessed by the Malaika. عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يعقد الشيطان على قافية رأس أحدكم إذا هو نام ثلاث عقد يضرب كل عقدة مكانها عليك ليل طويلة فارقد فإن استيقظ فذكر الله انحلت عقدة فإن توضأ انحلت عقدة فإن صلى انحلت عقده كلها فأصبح نشيطا طيب النفس وإلا أصبح خبيث النفس كسلان رواه البخاري. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, during your sleep, Shaytan, he comes and ties three knots behind your neck, behind at the back of the head of each and every one of you, and he breathes into every knot the following words: the night is long, so keep on sleeping. The night is long, so keep on sleeping. If that person wakes up and they remember Allah and praise Allah, Alhamdulillah, Alhamdulillah, الذي أحيانا بعد ما أماتنا وإليه النشور, or you praise Allah with any of the remembrances that are authentic, the one who remembers Allah, then one of those knots is undone. Then you go and you make wudu, the second knot is undone. And then when you establish the prayer, the third knot is undone. At that time, and he gets up till all three are undone. And then he gets up in the morning, lively and in good spirits, otherwise he gets up in low spirits and lethargic and lazy. Shaytan, who al adu al mubin, the avowed enemy, wanting nothing more than for you to leave, to miss, to abandon a prayer, to leave out some of your sujood, like he denied the sujood that he was commanded to do. This would make Shaytan very pleased. He's blowing those knots, and so try to go to sleep so that you can wake up on time. Make it an effort to make sure you wake up for the prayer, setting your alarm clock, having somebody help assist you to get up if you're a deeper sleeper or the likes of these matters. Defeat the shaytan. Allah said, وَأَقِمُ الصَّلَاةَ طَرَفِ النَّهَارِ وَزُلْفًا مِنَ اللَّيْلِ إِنَّ الْحَسَنَاتِ يُذْهِبْنَ السَّيِّئَاتِ ذَلِكَ ذِكْرَ لِلذَّاكِرِينَ. Allah says, what means an establish the prayer at the two ends of the day and at the approach of the night. Indeed, the good deeds do away with the misdeeds and erase them. This is a reminder for those who remember. This is a reminder for those who remember. So my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, the salah, the fara'id, especially of them, the five daily prayers that we're commanded to do, that differentiates between the believer and the disbeliever according to the strongest opinion. These are gifts, they're blessings from Allah. Your life should revolve around every prayer. Your trip, your work, to the best of your abilities, everything should revolve around the prayer, not your prayer revolving around what you're choosing to do in your life. Do not cut these prayers off. You are cutting off your connection with your Creator, with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So safeguard these prayers in their times, and don't be of those who destroy them themselves. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم والله يغفر لكم ذنوبكم. الحمد لله ثم الحمد لله الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله. الحمد لله غافر الذنوب جميعا لا شرك به. والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, these five daily prayers, they all, by Allah's hikmah, by Allah's wisdom, were placed and situated for us to remember Allah during the hustle and the bustle of life that could draw us away from Allah so that we just follow our desires. They were revealed, Kitab al-Mawquta, at times, fixed times, for us to turn and praise our Lord and honor our Lord and beg of our Lord, seeking His mercy and His forgiveness. Do not look at the prayer as a burden, because you will enter amongst those who are hypocrites. Look at the salah as the greatest of the gifts you are given with Islam, as part of Islam, where you can worship your Creator and find true sakina, true peace and true calmness, worshiping your Creator. the most neglected of the prayers in their times appears to be many times Salat al-Asr. And there are some specific ahadith and ayat that call out Salat al-Asr specifically with its virtue. So again, according to the ayah, Allah وَذَكِّرْ فَإِنَّ ذِكْرَ تَنْفَعُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ, remind one another, because reminding one another benefits the believers. May Allah make us from the mu'mineen. Then we want to remind ourselves of these virtues. The Asr prayer is great in the sight of Allah. When he said, حَافِظُوا عَلَى الصَّلَوَاتِ وَالصَّلَاةِ الْوُسْطَى وَقُومُوا لِلَّهِ قَانِتِينَ. When Allah said in Surah Al-Baqarah, what means guard strictly the five obligatory salawat, especially Salat al-Wusta. Especially Salat al-Wusta, and stand before Allah with obedience. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in a hadith that Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu narrated in Sunan al-Tirmidhi in al-Sahih, he said, Salat al-Wusta, Salat al-Asr. This Salat al-Wusta that Allah called out amongst all the five prayers, and we know the virtue we're seeing with Fajr and with Isha, Salat al-Wusta was called out. Guard strictly your five prayers, especially that middle prayer, and stand before Allah with obedience. Ibn Umar radiallahu anhuma, he narrated that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, الَّذِي تَفُوتُهُ صَلَاةُ الْعَصْرِ فَكَأَنَّمَا وُتِرَ أَهْلَهُ وَمَالَهُ. رواه الترمذي وهذا حديث صحيح. Ibn Umar radiallahu anhuma, he narrated that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whoever misses the Asr prayer, then it is as if he was robbed of his family. That as if he lost his whole family and his property. Now you tell me, if I told you that you would lose your whole family and all of your property, if you didn't do such an act, would you then not do it? You would race to it. You would make sure that it's done because you see it as a tangible thing. This hadith is clear proof that the one who misses Salat al-Asr, lets Salat al-Asr go by, it would be better that you lose all your family members and every penny you have, that you become homeless on the street and have nobody to fend for you but your Creator, than for you to miss that Asr prayer. Yet many times we focus on the importance of Fajr and Isha only, or praying Maghrib on time, and we belittle this Salat al-Asr, this Salat al-Wusta, this middle prayer. Shaykh Muhammad Mazmoor, Habibullah, he said that the scholars say that perhaps the wisdom behind Salat al-Asr being mentioned is when the people are very busy at that time in trade or roaming about the markets. Or it's the hardest time for those who are in jobs or occupations, for they return to their homes, maybe tired. They say, let me take a little nap, and they wake up and it's Maghrib time. Abi al-Malih, he narrated, he said, we were with Burayda in a battle on a cloudy day. And he said, offer the Asr prayer early. Because the Prophet ﷺ, he said, مَنْ تَرَكَ صَلَاةِ الْعَصْرِ فَقَدْ حَبِطَ عَمَلَهُ. رواه البخاري. Prophet Muhammad ﷺ, he was quoted to have said, whoever leaves the Asr prayer, all of his good deeds will become annulled. Now notice the wording. They were there, it was a cloudy day. The command was offer the Asr prayer early, at the beginning of its time. Praying it at that time. Because if you don't pray it even early, it's like leaving it. The ones who delay Asr to pray it when the sun is setting, it's as if you've left the salah and didn't pray it. And Al-Ala'u, he narrated to us that he entered upon Anas ibn Malik in the house of Al-Basra when he had finished Dhuhr. And his house was beside the masjid. فَلَمَّا دَخَلْنَا عَلَيْهِ قَالَ أَصَلَّيْتُمُ الْعَصَرِ قُلْنَا لَا إِنَّمَا أَنْصَرَفْنَا السَّاعَةَ مِنَ الظُّهُرِ قَالَ فَصَلُّوا الْعَصَرِ قَالَ فَقُمْنَا فَصَلَّيْنَا فَلَمَّا انْصَرَفْنَا قَالَ سَمِعْتُ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول تلك صلاة المنافق جلس يرقب صلاة العصر حتى إذا كانت بين قرن الشيطان قام فنقر أربعا لا يذكر الله عز وجل فيها إلا قليلا. This hadith which we find in the Sunan al-Tirmidhi and Nisa'i, he said to them at the time, have you prayed Asr? He said, Anas Abdi Malik, he said to them, have you prayed Asr? They said, no, we had just finished Dhuhr. He said, pray Asr. So we got up and prayed. And when we finished, he said, I heard the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, that is the prayer of the hypocrite. He sits and delays the Asr prayer until the sun is between the horns of shaitan. And then he gets up and he pecks, this is the word used, he pecks his head on the ground 4 times, 4 rak'ahs, in which he only remembers Allah a little. For the one who delays the Asr, this is called Salat al-Munafiq, the one who delays it to the end of its time. Pecking, praying it so fast, making sure he gets it in before Maghrib. He's done and you hear the adhan for Maghrib start to go off. This Asr prayer continues to have special virtues along with it. عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يتعاقبون فيكم ملائكة بالليل وملائكة بالنهار ويجتمعون في صلاة العصر وصلاة الفجر ثم يعرج الذي باتوا فيكم فيسألهم وهو أعلم بكم فيقول كيف تركتم عبادي فيقولون تركناهم وهم يصلون وآتيناهم وهم يصلون رواه البخاري. Allah's Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم said, a group of the angels stay with you at night, and another group of angels, they stay with you during daytime. And both groups, they gather at 2 times before they switch shifts. They gather at Salat al-Fajr, the Fajr time, and Salat al-Asr, at the Asr time. Then those angels who were with you overnight, when the angels who are going to be with you during the day come, and they both groups witness you at Fajr time praying, or witnessing you at Asr time praying, when that salah is done, the group that was with you from the night, they go back to Allah, and the group that's with you today stays with you till Asr time, and then they switch shifts again. Each time they go back to Allah, and Allah, even though He knows what you are doing, and He knows very well, fully aware of what everyone is doing, He still asks the angels, what did you find my slaves and servants doing? And the angels say, تَرَقْنَاهُمْ وَهُمْ يُصَلُونَ. We left them, they were praying. وَأَتَيْنَاهُمْ وَهُمْ يُصَلُونَ. And we came to them when they're praying. Look at that honor. Look at that honor that the angels would mention your names to Allah Azza wa Jalla, even though Allah is also knowing what you're doing and witnessing you. Mentioning your names to Allah Azza wa Jalla because of your persistence in praying Fajr and Asr prayers on time. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, let us know that these prayers are special. These prayers were given to us with Allah's wisdom. They should have been 50, but they were reduced to 5 in number with the reward of 50. But they must be prayed in their time. They must be prayed in their time. So that you don't fall of those who pray them as a performance, but you could be in a punishment in Jahannam. فَوَيْلٌ لِلْمُصَلِّينَ الَّذِينَ هُمْ عَنْ صَلَاتِهِمْ سَاهُونَ. So wail, humiliation, grief. In some narrations, wail is like a river in the hellfire. For the musalleen, those performers of the prayer, those who delay their prayers from their fixed times. We don't want to be in this category. The prayers were established at fixed times. A blessing and a gift. Make your life revolve around them. Do not revolve. Make your life revolve around your prayers. Do not revolve your prayers around your life. Pray them in their times. Look at the virtues of what you can attain by praying Fajr and Asr and Isha and the likes of all of the fara'id. And if we do so, then inshallah we will be raised as believers yawm al-qiyamah. اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك أنت سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وانصرنا على أعدائك وأعداء الدين اللهم انصر إخواننا وأخواتنا في فلسطين اللهم نفس كروبهم وسهل أمورهم وثبت أقدامهم وارحم موتاهم واشف مرضاهم وتقبل شهداءهم يا رب العالمين سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين.